गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? फाइन, ओके, वेरी गुड स्टूडेंट्स. नाउ इज द सेशन ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स. एज यूजुअली इट हैपेंस एवरी डे एट दिस टाइम. एंड इन दिस सेशन ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द न्यू टॉपिक ऑफ द फर्स्ट चैप्टर. And that is about production possibility curve. Okay, already we have discussed about the economic problems, which are allocation of resources, fuller and efficient utilization of resources, and growth of resources, and the central problems also, like what to produce, how to produce, and for whom to produce, etc. We have discussed. Okay, so now today let us proceed to discuss the next topic, and that is the production possibility curve. You know students, when we say production possibility curve, then it refers to a graphical presentation of all those possible combinations or bundles of the two goods which can be produced in an economy by utilizing its resources fully and efficiently and in a given state of technology. Okay, so before explaining what is called production possibility curve, let us first discuss what are called production possibilities. You know students, in every economic state given a stock of the resources, as well as there is a given a state of technology, and the stock of resources in all the economies of the world, in all the countries, is not same, is not alike. Some countries have abundant of one resources but lack of another resources. Some countries have lack of one resources but abundant of another resources. Okay, so the resource distribution across different countries are not equal. And the same way, technological conditions of all the countries of the world, of all the economies of the world, are also not same, are also not alike. Okay, so you will find that the productive capacity, the economic strength of every economy will also not be the same. Okay, normally you can say a country having maximum resources, more and more resources, will have high capacity to produce goods and services, and a country having less of resources will have low capacity to produce goods and services. Similarly, from technology point of view, if a country has very high technological condition, very advanced technological condition, then its productive capacity will also be very high. And if the technological condition is advanced but backward, then productive capacity of that economy will also be very low. So in fact, the maximum production capacity, productive capacity of any economy primarily depends on the two things. It depends on several things, but primarily it depends on the two factors, two things. Number one, availability of the resources. Number two, technological condition. Okay, so depending on the availability of resources, एंड टेक्नोलॉजिकल कंडीशन, देयर हैपेंस टू बी मैक्सिमम कैपेसिटी, मैक्सिमम पोटेंशियल, मैक्सिमम पावर ऑफ एन इकोनॉमी टू प्रोड्यूस डिफरेंट गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज. सो व्हेन वी से प्रोडक्शन पॉसिबिलिटीज, देन इट रेफर्स टू ऑल दोज पॉसिबल कॉम्बिनेशंस और बंडल्स ऑफ डिफरेंट गुड्स विच कैन बी प्रोड्यूस्ड इन एन इकोनॉमी बाई यूटिलाइजिंग इट्स रिसोर्सेज फुल्ली एंड इफिशियंटली. ओके, इफ वी एज्यूम दैट देर इज अ गिवन स्टॉक ऑफ रिसोर्सेज इन एन इमेजनरी इकोनॉमी एंड देर इज अ गिवन टेक्नोलॉजिकल कंडीशन ऑल्सो, देन डिपेंडिंग ऑन दीज टू फैक्टर्स द मैक्सिमम अमाउंट ऑफ गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज विच कैन बी प्रोड्यूस्ड इन सच एन इकोनॉमी विल बी कॉल्ड इट्स प्रोडक्शन पॉसिबिलिटी. इफ वी एज्यूम दैट देर आर ओनली टू गुड्स एक्स एंड वाई टू बी प्रोड्यूस्ड इन द इकोनॉमी, देन वी कैन डिफाइन प्रोडक्शन पॉसिबिलिटीज एज ए सेट ऑफ ऑल दोज पॉसिबल कॉम्बिनेशंस और बंडल्स ऑफ द टू गुड्स विच कैन बी प्रोड्यूस्ड इन एन इकोनॉमी बाय यूटिलाइजिंग इट्स रिसोर्सेज फुल्ली एंड इफिशियंटली एंड इन ए गिवन स्टेट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी. ओके, यू मे हैव कन्फ्यूजन इन अंडरस्टैंडिंग द कॉम्बिनेशंस और बंडल्स. Suppose students, there are two goods X and Y, and suppose you form different bundles, different combinations of these two goods. Then suppose you form bundle 1, bundle A, in which there is 1 unit of X and 20 units of Y, then it is combination 1, choice 1 or bundle 1 which can be produced. Another combination also, suppose you form combination B, then in it there will be 2 units of X and suppose 18 units of Y, then it is another combination or bundle of the two goods which can be produced. Similarly, if you form another combination like C, in which there are 3 units of commodity X, good X, and suppose 14 units of Y, then it is another combination or bundle or choice which can be produced in the economy. So similarly, so many other bundles, other combinations like D, E, F, G, H, I can also be formed on the basis of the requirement of the economy, and the choice of each bundle will depend on the requirement of the economy. Okay, so the number of bundles or number of combinations which can be formed of the two goods, so it shows in fact the production potential, production capacity or production possibilities. These bundles, these combinations collectively will be called as production possibilities. Okay, so how will you define production possibilities? If I ask you, you can define it as a set of all those possible combinations or bundles of the two goods which can be produced in an economy by utilizing its resources fully and efficiently and in a given state of technology. Okay, if you present all these combinations or bundles of the two goods which can be produced in the form of a table, already you know what is called table. In a statistics part, in you will study the construction of a table. In fact, table is a set of rows and columns to present the data. So students, if you present the informations or the data related to the quantities of the two goods X and Y in different combinations or bundles through a table, by constructing a table, then it will be called production possibility schedule. Already, when the data are presented through a table, then it becomes a schedule. Then how will you define production possibility schedule? It can be defined as a tabular presentation. A tabular presentation of what? A tabular presentation of all those possible combinations or bundles of the two goods which can be produced in an economy by utilizing its resources fully and efficiently and in a given state of technology. So this will be called as production possibility schedule. If you present the same informations of different production possibilities with the help of a graph or diagram, then it will be called production possibility curve. In a statistics part, you will study how to construct a graph. What is a graph? What is a diagram? A diagram, in fact, is the presentation of data in the form of lines and curves. Okay? So when you present the data, the informations related to different production possibilities with a graph, with a diagram. So students, if you present the informations or the data related to the quantities of the two goods X and Y in different combinations or bundles through a table, by constructing a table, then it will be called production possibility schedule. Already, when the data are presented through a table, then it becomes a schedule. Then how will you define production possibility schedule? It can be defined as a tabular presentation. A tabular presentation of what? A tabular presentation of all those possible combinations or bundles of the two goods which can be produced in an economy by utilizing its resources fully and efficiently and in a given state of technology. So this will be called as production possibility schedule. If you present the same informations of different production possibilities with the help of a graph or diagram, then it will be called production possibility curve. In a statistics part, you will study how to construct a graph. What is a graph? What is a diagram? A diagram, in fact, is the presentation of data in the form of lines and curves. Okay? So when you present the data, the informations related to different production possibilities with a graph, with a diagram, then possibility curve, very minutely you will find that there are two basic characteristics, the two basic features of a production possibility curve, that is called PP curve in short. What are these two basic features? What are these two basic characteristics? Let us explain. The first basic characteristics of a PP curve is that it is negatively sloped, that means sloping downward from left to right. You know, students, why it is so? It is because of the negative relationship between the two goods X and Y. ओके, एज वी प्रोसीड फ्रॉम वन कॉम्बिनेशन टू अनदर, फ्रॉम वन बंडल टू अनदर अलोंग द पीपी कर्व, व्हाट हैपेंस यू नो, सम अमाउंट ऑफ गुड एग्स विल राइज एंड इन स्टीड ऑफ दैट सम अमाउंट ऑफ गुड वाइफ विल हैव टू बी सेक्रीफाइस्ड. ओके, सो एज द अमाउंट ऑफ एग्स इंक्रीजेस द अमाउंट ऑफ वाई डिक्रीजेस, एंड इफ द अमाउंट ऑफ वाई इंक्रीजेस द अमाउंट द क्वांटिटी ऑफ एग्स डिक्रीजेस. सो ए निगेटिव रिलेशनशिप इज फॉर्म्ड बिटवीन द टू गुड्स एग्स एंड वाई इन कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ पीपी कर्व, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस निगेटिव रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द टू गुड्स एग्स एंड वाई द पीपी कर्व हैपन्स टू बी स्लोपिंग डाउनवर्ड फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, द सेकेंड इंपॉर्टेंट फीचर ऑफ ए पीपी कर्व इज दैट इट इज कनकेव टू द पॉइंट ऑफ ओरिजिन. इट इज कनकेव टू द पॉइंट ऑफ ओरिजिन बिकॉज ऑफ वॉट, इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ द इनक्लिनल अपॉर्चुनिटी कॉस्ट. वॉट अबाउट मार्जिनल अपॉर्चुनिटी कॉस्ट, देर इज ए नीड ऑफ सेपरेट एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑन दिस, बट एट प्रेजेंट सिंस इट इज रेलिवेंट, सो यू शुड नो दैट मार्जिनल अपॉर्चुनिटी कॉस्ट इन फैक्ट इज द रेट ऑफ सेक्रीफाइस इन टर्म्स ऑफ वन कमोडिटी टू प्रोड्यूस सम एडिशनल अमाउंट ऑफ अनदर कमोडिटी. एज फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ यू प्रोसीड फ्रॉम कॉम्बिनेशन ए टू कॉम्बिनेशन बी अलॉन्ग द पीपी कर्व, यू विल फाइंड दैट द क्वांटिटी ऑफ एग्स हैज इंक्रीज्ड फ्रॉम वन टू टू, वेयर एज इन ऑर्डर टू प्रोड्यूस वन एडिशनल यूनिट ऑफ गुड एग्स टू यूनिट्स ऑफ वाई हैज टू बी सेक्रीफाइस्ड. सो द कॉस्ट ऑफ प्रोड्यूसिंग वन यूनिट ऑफ एग्स हियर इज द टू यूनिट्स ऑफ वाई, दैट विल बी कॉल्ड एज मार्जिनल अपॉर्चुनिटी कॉस्ट. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, and as we move from one combination to another, from one bundle to another along the PP curve, then you know what happens. This MOC, this rate of sacrifice, this marginal opportunity cost keeps increasing. This is because of a perfect indigibility of the factors of the resources, and it is because of the specialization of the factors or resources that I will explain in detail later on after completing this topic. So because MOC is increasing while we move from one combination or bundle to another along the PP curve, makes the PP curve concave to the origin. So students, from this discussion we may conclude now that a PP curve is sloping downward from left to right, number one, and a PP curve is concave to the origin, number two. So along with this, I would like to finish my lecture today. Already I have explained this topic, the meaning and features of PP curve. So I hope that you will go through this topic in detail in something better way from your textbook. And tomorrow also I will proceed for the next topic. So till then I would like to say thank you very much.